I don't know if you know this, but I don't speak Russian!
So they took Chinese throwing stars and chucked them at the wall in the drywall, and it stuck into the drywall. They thought that was pretty cool. It is. It's like a human Jenga thing. Thousands of ping pong balls dropped out of the ceiling. Hey, welcome to Comedy Parenting Radio. Once again, my name's Jerry Begley, and you're listening to the show that keeps more mosquitoes off of your porch than any other show. Well, today we're going to be talking about ping pong, and we got all the ping pong experts in the room. How are you guys all doing?
Good. Good.
Absolutely marvelous.
I wanted to know about Josiah. What happened right before the show? What happened to your arm?
It got sliced open, kind of.
How did you slice it open?
No reason. It just popped open.
skin doesn't normally just pop open like that. Well, anyway, we'll be right back with some ping pong experts.
Ew.
Comedy Parenting Radio, coming right back. 99 red balloons floating in the summer sky. Panic bears, that's red alert. There's something here from somewhere else. The war machine springs to life.
Are you stuck with a bratty little kid for the rest of the day? Maybe it's your grandkid, your neighbor's kid, or your own little brat because your spouse is a lousy parent. In any event, you can save yourself a big headache if you give them a copy of Dad the Tooth Fairy Didn't Come to look at. The funny pictures and big vocabulary will keep them busy for hours and hours while you sit on the couch and check your Facebook account. If you're looking for some peace and quiet, order your copy of Dad the Tooth Fairy Didn't Come from Amazon today.
You are now free to move about the cabin.
He's bound it down, loaded up and trucking. Are we gonna do what they say can't be done? We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there.
Okay, it's Comedy Parenting Radio, and today we're talking about ping pong balls, guys, and ping pong. We've got a ping pong table down in our basement, and how long have you guys been playing ping pong?
About a year.
More than a year.
We've been playing it
for like 7 years.
3 days.
Well, since we actually started playing.
How about since we got it cleaned up down in the basement?
Yeah.
About 7 days.
Yeah, about a week now. We had some really big piles of stuff down in the basement around the ping pong table.
Yeah.
For example, what?
Ski boots.
I was going to say ski boots and books are the main offenders, and boxes and boxes.
And antiques from...
antiques from old times.
Yeah, and Nigeria and stuff.
Oh, and Nigerian things, yeah. Anyway, we finally got that stuff cleaned up, but before that, when we were playing ping pong, if the ball went off the table, it was kind of a disaster, wasn't it?
It was gone forever.
Yeah, for Christmas, I bought the Mongo box of ping pong balls, and we would play ping pong, and all of a sudden, there went the ball sailing off into no man's land, and you couldn't find it, could you?
No, I think when we finally got it all cleaned up, I believe we found over 20 ping pong balls.
Yeah.
In good condition, too, weren't they?
Mint condition, yes.
Mint condition. Mint-flavored ping pong balls.
Just out of the box.
The funny thing is that when, like now, sometimes you'll hit the ball, and it'll go off into a certain place, and you'll go over there, and you'll find, like, 5 ping pong balls with it.
Right. So the ping pong balls are blooming in our basement, aren't they?
Yes.
Yeah, they're all over. We still have like the camping section, right?
Yep.
And the toy game section. Those are all shelved units, nice and tidy. But we still have a bunch of boxes to clean up, don't we?
Books. Yep. Lots and lots of books.
Oh my word, books. Somebody made you know how kids make blanket forts?
Mm-hmm.
They made a book fort.
Yeah, we tunneled through the
tunneled, yeah.
Through the giant pile of books. book boxes and stuff. What we do is we go in there, take out the box, and pile it on top. And go in there, take out the box, and put it on top.
Jenga.
Dangerous life-size Jenga.
It is. It's like a human Jenga thing. So you pull out the wrong one, we're going to have this 5,000 pounds of books coming down on your head.
Yep.
Okay. You're listening to Comedy Parenting Radio. We're talking about ping pong at the Begley House. We'll be back right away.
You got to take care of Texas. It's the only one we got. If you're way up in Lubbock or down in Lucanbach, got to conserve water, keep the air clean. Take care of Texas. Don't you know what I mean, y'all? Kevin Fowler here. Texas has clean air, rivers, and lakes. So let's get outdoors and enjoy them. Visit TakeCareOfTexas.org. Pledge to help keep it that way, and we'll mail you a free Texas State Park Guide.
Take care of Texas, it's the only one we got.
Sponsored by the Texas Commission on Environmental Quality and Texas Parks and Wildlife.
Norm Ballone is a retailer. He doesn't use radio because...
can't see things in radio.
So to show him that hearing is seeing, we blindfolded Norm and tied him to a chair in his living room.
What are you doing?
We're sawing a hole in your floor, Norm.
Listen, I know radio works. It's okay, really.
Now we're filling the hole with water.
I like radio, I do.
Now we're throwing alligators and sharks in the hole.
No, please, take off the blindfold!
So, Norm, still think you can't see things on radio?
Well, not like TV.
All right, I can see! I can see!
A message from this station and the Radio Advertising Bureau.
You know, the question I get asked most often is, Tony, how do you go to the bathroom in the suit?
Sir, the attitude is not going to speed things up any bit at all.
I hear the drums echoing tonight. She hears only whispers of...
Comedy Parenting Radio, talking about ping pong. Josiah, what did you want to say?
There is a national park down there made out of the books. It's quite the newest one, but it's not be able to be gone into.
Do you need a pass or an entrance fee to get in your national park? Or is it a free one?
It's a free one.
And what do they see down there?
You get to see all the tunneling one. It was actually one of the biggest ones.
Is this called Human Jenga National Park?
No, probably. Yeah, it is. Most of the structure has been taken down, but this one, the old one, it used to be 3 stories tall.
Well, anyway, ping pong has been going around for a long time. I've been playing ping pong since I was just a little guy, and my dad never had a nice ping pong table. He had a 4x8 sheet of plywood that he painted gray.
What was that?
And put it out on the patio out behind our house.
Did it bounce better or worse than regular ping pong tables now?
It bounced just the same, except for one thing. He got the cheap plywood.
Yeah.
And it was the kind that was not smooth, like AC plywood is super smooth on the A side.
So it's not. It was like the...
CDX, which is exterior plywood. And so on the good side of the plywood, which was up and painted, actually had knot holes in it.
Those must have been fun.
Well, if you could aim the ping pong ball for the knot hole, occasionally it would take a wild bounce and go off the table, and the guy had no chance of getting the ball. You know, another thing that was a big ping pong thing when I was a kid? Captain Kangaroo. Ever heard of that?
Yep.
Yes.
Yeah, it was a children's show when I was little, and it was really, really lame by today's standards.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Well, today's standards
are pretty high.
No, actually, it's
pretty low.
Well,
yeah. We have some pretty lame
standards you're talking
this
about.
Is before Teletubbies and before it really went down to mindless drivel. They had actually pretty cool
rats.
Stuff. This is back in the days, like not long after color television was invented.
Rat Patrol.
No, this is before Rat Patrol.
Yeah, but that same
anyway
time.
On Captain Kangaroo, one of the things that happened is Mr. Moose would be out there, and Mr. Moose was a puppet. And the captain, they were standing behind a big desk. And if the captain said the wrong word, guess what happened?
He got splatted or something.
No. Thousands of ping pong balls dropped out of the ceiling. This was pretty cool for a little kid to see all these ping pong balls just falling out of the sky onto his head. And, of course, the captain... He pretended that it was completely a disaster that happened. And the moose loved it. The moose was like... You know who I don't want to be?
Who?
The guy who picks up all those ping pong balls after they drop and go all over the studio floor.
50-ball pickup.
I had to do that before because the boys, they took the Christmas ping pong balls and they put them in a box and they would stick them above your doorway so you would come into your room or into the art studio and then all of a sudden, poof.
Oh, yeah. I've been victim of the ping pong ball door trap also myself. Okay, Comedy Parenting Radio, we'll be back.
I don't believe it. My savings are gone. They're gone.
You're kidding.
Nope, they're gone. They're gone.
Okay, all right. Think about it. Where did you have them last?
I remember I was home, then I took them, and then I spent them on that vacation to Aruba. Then I bought this miniature suit of armor I saw in the in-flight magazine.
And that's the last you saw of your savings?
Yes.
This is so weird.
I know, right?
Weird? Not really. Not saving now means no money later. You'd be surprised how quickly a little money from every paycheck can really add up. Put away a few bucks, feel like $1 million. For free ideas and easy ways to save, go to feedthepig.org. That's
feedthepig.org. The armor is cool, though. Oops. I think I broke its gauntlet.
You broke my favorite part.
This message brought to you by the American Institute of Certified Public Accountants and the Ad Council.
You don't understand. Something really bad is about to happen here.
Nobody gets too much heaven no more.
Is this a kissing book?
I'm the clever one. You're the potato one.
Too much love anymore.
You look like a blueberry.
I gotta say it, it's hard to get a read on you,
Who has a sonic screwdriver?
I do!
Lights!
Who looks at a screwdriver and thinks, ooh, this could be a little more sonic?
Code red, we have a breach.
No reward is worth this.
We played round robin ping pong when I was in college in the dormitories. And there's nothing quite in the world like having, 10 to 20 guys that are 18 years old playing round robin.
You probably
That's
got to
be
the ball
insane.
Once.
It was very insane and very wild and lots of screaming. And I think in the resident assistant down below our rec room, they probably had plaster falling off the walls.
Well, why did you build your place there?
I didn't do it. We just showed up, and that's the way it was. Jerry Austin was awesome at ping pong. He was from Montrose, Colorado. And if you know Montrose, there's really nothing going on out there. So they probably played ping pong 24 hours a day at his house.
Probably.
And on round robin, Jerry Austin could scoop the paddle up, dive for the floor, and get the ball just as it was about hitting the carpet, and go, and go back up on the other side.
Wow.
He was awesome.
You've done that a couple times now, haven't you?
Yeah, almost. But I don't like concrete. The carpet would have been better if we had carpet down there. but another thing that we did in the recreation room up there.
What?
Two guys who bought Chinese throwing stars.
And
then they decided that they would try throwing it at the wall to see if it would stick. And it did. It stuck. And so they took Chinese throwing stars and chucked them at the wall in the drywall, and it stuck into the drywall. They thought that was pretty cool. After we went to bed, seeing about, 5 or 10 holes in the wall, we woke up the next morning, and the entire wall was covered with Chinese throwing star holes.
Oh, boy.
They had somebody come and repair that. Those two guys had to pay about $300 or $400 to have the holes repaired in the wall. Okay, you've been listening to Comedy Parenting Radio talking about ping pong. Thanks for coming out today, gang.
You're welcome.
Yep.
And last one to the ping pong table is a rotten egg. Bye.
There you go. Yep. Camping gear.
13-11.
This is the most fun I ever had recording a show.
She just.
to the entire...